Hi all, it's Cindy from Cindy's Art. Today we're going to do a quick watercolor painting with pen and ink on it as well. And I went into Unsplash and I found this blue door that I am going to turn into a greeting card for somebody. And I started off with a quick pencil drawing. Take the time to draw your painting out before you start. It really does help when you're working on it. And I started off with a quick wet on wet wash. And I love the concrete that's in this painting, but I wanted to keep a yellow tone to it and start that off. So I am putting my yellow wash as my base. This is the underpainting. And then I am gonna go ahead and start sketching in some of the blue. I wanna identify where the light blue is gonna be, where the light tones are, and then I'll start to develop the picture even more. After getting some of my original colors just laid in there, I like to see the contrast. So I put in the light, and then I'm going to put in some of the contrast so I can look and see where the lines are while I continue to work on this painting. It'll help me identify where to put the dark tones in and what I need to keep light. This is a Mincho Micron pen, which means it's got a very small tip. And I got a whole pack of them. So they have a variety of sizes from like a 0.001 all the way up to 2.0. These are excellent to have. I'll put this in my description below so you can take a look at this. You can buy individual pens or you can buy the larger pens. I think it's worth it if you're gonna try pen and ink with watercolor to get the mixture of the pack, because you'll start sketching and you're gonna want something larger at times. You're gonna want something very small and minute. Concrete, it is the same as looking at snow. What other types of colors are in there? I could find some orange tones. I could find some yellow ochre tones. I would use a permanent orange on this and just a tiny, tiny bit. But look at what colors are actually inside of something that looks so plain. There actually is more color. You could use a little tiny bit of red inside of a brick tone. I'm using, this is like a raw sienna mixture in. This is a burnt sienna now. And I should be using a little bit of orange in here in a few minutes. I'm looking at what will keep the concrete warm. If things are closer to you, you want more warmth. If it's away from you, you want to put cooler tones to it, so that way it kind of adds space. So that's something to that's good to remember when you're working on your watercolor paintings. I'm coming into the final details of my painting. At this point, I'm looking at what does it look like right now? What do I want it to look like finished? Do I want to put more details on the cement? Do I want to have more details to the pot? Do I want to add a little bit more color in there? When I look at the door and I look at the frame, what's supposed to be close to me? What's supposed to be further away? Do I need to add some neutral, or which is a blackish tone, or do I want to use some indigo, which is a dark blue? Do I want to use those colors to put on here and create a light wash so I can have a wall that's in the back look like it's in the back and not in the front? And then the door frame and the door, I would want to make sure that door frame has a little bit more yellow to it. Maybe a tiny bit more orange. Why? Because I want things that are in the forefront to have a little bit of warmth to it. So take your time, set your painting aside for a few days if you need to, and think about it, look at it, and decide and poke around and try different things. So I was so glad to have this time with you guys today. Please hit subscribe, and I look forward to seeing you the next time.